we made it happen, man. It's been a few weeks, but I'm glad that you guys made it down, man.
Yeah, you're done now. Big up Mr. ILLATEK. Out to the whole of the Westside Massive. Yeah, you're done now.
So, man, just been talking a little bit off mic. You're just getting yourselves ready. So, is everything all right with that?
That's
all right. Freestyle it.
Is that not working? All right, we'll get Martin Mose sorted out,
I'm
man.
I'm there, can you hear me, yeah?
We can hear you.
Yeah, we can hear you, we can hear you.
We can hear you and see you.
Live and clear, man. So tell us, Bush, man, what's been going on with you?
Boy, it's just been, you know, it's been crazy. A crazy year so far for Heartless Crew.
Yeah.
Been up and down the country, flying around internationally.
Yeah.
Licking down bear raves, badding up the studio.
Yeah.
Yeah, man, it's just getting off, mate.
What about yourself, man? Everything cool with you, brother?
Yeah, everything is blessed, man.
Now, things have, for people who may not have heard from you in a little while on Westside FM, you know, like, things have changed for you recently, right? You've been into production for a little while, but now you're kind of, it seems to me like you're kind of stepping up a gear in terms of getting into the studio. You've done a remix of Alicia Keys, right? The Metric Moses remix.
Yeah.
Doing a few things there. Bushkin, you got your record label popping off.
Yeah.
So tell the people, you know, what's kind of happening with you boys, man?
Right, everything's been popping off. I mean, you know, we were sucked into the club world, you know, with the bookings every weekend and flying here and flying there, going up and down the country. And sometimes it's hard to make time to squeeze everything else in, but it's like, man want to do that. Man want to do everything, really. So it's just about stepping up the pace and getting on this thing, as they say.
That's the way to do it, man.
Uh-huh. Yeah, and I'd just say, like, you know what? A few years back, Heartless was signed up to a major record label.
That was Warner Atlantic,
that was
right?
Warner Atlantic, East West Warner. And I mean, it was all right. We was there for, I think, about a year and a half. At least one or two tunes with them, had a load of material shelved, and then in the end we got released. It was a good deal on our behalf because we got to keep our music and the money that they gave us. But I mean, after that experience, personally, I thought to myself, you know what, I wouldn't really want any artist to go through that kind of experience again.
Was that difficult for you? Because obviously I worked at East West at the time.
Yeah.
So I remember seeing your stuff on the shelves and then I was thinking, what must it be like to have all your stuff ready to go?
Of course.
You had videos done, all the rest of it.
Yeah.
And then the momentum just stops.
That's right. Yeah. And then we felt a way, basically. Obviously, as an artist, you put your time, your effort and your soul into your music and writing stuff down. And then obviously to have it show up, it ain't a good feeling.
Yeah.
I mean, we had done the circuit through and through. We'd done the whole of the UK. And when we signed with the record label, we thought, all right, this is our time to blow now.
Yeah.
We're going to go worldwide and it's going to go crazy. And they started sending us back up to places like Mossside, Manchester, where we had already been 6 years prior off our own back.
Already,
And we was like, this ain't what you're supposed to be doing for us. I mean, and after that whole experience, I said to myself, you know what? I don't like that feeling as an artist, and I don't want any other artist to kind of go through that again.
Mm.
And that's when I came up with the concept of Bush Bash Recordings.
Yeah.
And what is this? A label for the artist by an artist.
Yeah.
Because I mean, as an artist myself, I know how I'd like to be treated, and I know how artists should be treated.
Mm.
Yeah, man, and little by little things been building up, and I mean, yeah, for the last kind of 2.5 months, it's been going crazy. Got two artists on the label, Shizzle and Discreet. Shizzle's in the building here.
We got Shizzle in the place.
He's going to tear up the airways in a little while. Yeah, man. It's been going off, man. We've made some videos. We've done a tune. And Shizzle brought myself and Mighty Mo on the collaboration alongside Gemma Fox.
It's a hot record, man.
So, yeah, I mean, yeah, it's just been going off. And I mean, the bookings are flying in. The PAs are flying in. We done a massive thing for Khan, but yeah, it's just going crazy again, and we're loving the momentum at the moment.
That's what it's all about, man. Now, the thing with you guys is, yeah, you, out of all the crews that came from your era, is like, you lot just had a totally different vibe to everyone else, and I think you blatantly have the most fanatic fans out there of any of the crews. Do you know what I mean? You lot, like I was just saying off mic, you lot could do pretty much anything, and I think a lot of your fans would blatantly just lap it up.
Well, big up to the fans then, because if it weren't for them, we're nothing. But you know what it is, fam? Man put their heart and soul into this thing. That's why we're Heartless, do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
And people can feel that, and they can see it, and they can hear it, do you know what I mean? Man on this thing, to all the Heartless fans out there,
yeah, man.
We love you, don't worry.
You're keeping
them busy.
We're
still flying the flag high, real high.
Now you can be seen on MySpace. It's myspace.com/heartlesscrew.
Yep.
That's the original, the official one as well.
Yeah, we're there on Facebook as well. We're regularly on the Facebook, updating it. And of course now the new thing as well, the Twitter thing.
Yeah.
All over that. Like
are you
a rash.
On Twitter quite a lot? Who's the biggest Twitterer out of you two, do you reckon?
Well, ain't no twits in this crew, bro.
Which one do you reckon? Or is it, what about Fonty? Is Fonty on the Twitter?
Shizzle's the biggest.
Yeah.
Out of the camp, definitely. Shizzle's on, he's the Twitter done at the moment, but I'm catching him up. And Mighty Mo's been going hard on Twitter recently. Smasher's all over it as well.
I see
Smasher's tweet, going to link Bush Bash, Westside Radio. Shizzle just Westsided it up. I just Westsided it. You ain't
Westside?
You Westsided it, Mighty Mo?
I'll do it right now.
All right.
My battery died, but I just recharge it.
Yeah. Westside it up, mate.
Yeah, man.
Add to the Twitter crew, follow us. Shizzle, MC, Smasher, Metric Moses and myself, Bush Bash.
So tell us about this tune then. It's called The Greatest.
The Greatest.
Bush Bash Recordings. It's you, Shizzle, Mighty Mo, Gemma Fox.
Fox
been away for a little while, man. It's good to see her back.
No, man, we got a few bits of Gemma Fox still, and she's working on an album at the moment. So yeah, man, big up Gemma Fox. I just confirmed today with her, funny enough, I'm going to be doing a birthday party for her on the 28th of November, Saturday the 28th. So yeah, look out for that. And yeah, man, The Greatest. It was actually Shizzle's concept.
Yeah.
We got a beat from one of our in-camp producers, Sly Ranger. And said, Shizzle, fire this one up. And Shizzle done exactly that. He called it The Greatest. He wrote a great verse. He dragged me in the studio, kicking and screaming. I laid down something.
Yeah.
And then I done the same to Mighty Mo, although he wasn't kicking and screaming.
I love it, mate.
All right, how about, let's go into this tune, man. Let's hear what it's all about. This is The Greatest right here. How about you introduce it, man? You just take over, do your thing.
How about Shizzle introduce it?
Yeah, how about Shizzle? Step up to the mic, man. Right. Shizzle inside the place.
In the building!
Why don't you introduce this tune for us, brother?
I'm a shorty, I'm 5'7", you know. So I have to edit this.
Edit that mic down.
What's happening, people?
Everything's all good,
man. This one's called The Greatest. As Bushkin said, I come up with a concept. Hold tight, Sly Ranger, he produced the beat. From I heard the beat, it had a dancehall vibe to it. I know Bush, you know, Mighty, they've got that dancehall vibe in them. I'm obviously got it. So I thought, you know what? Let's get it popping. And obviously with these guys, as you said, they're great at what they do and they've put their heart and soul into it.
That's
so
it,
the only title I could come with was The Greatest.
That's a good title, man.
Here it is right now.
Sure. Right, let's do this. Heartless Crew runs in the place. Addictive like when you kick in jars with the plates and crazy. Spread them out like sauce, no biting there. We great, we no move the gate. Them boy they can't figure out what's time. We not the gate, come to the gate.
We no move in the gate, them boy they can't figure our style. We no be gay, gums up to the gate, fast accelerate gate.
She said, don't know, see a better than them.
Too much bars, I was spitting 16, can't tell the gate.